the initial words. And good evening, friends. And I'm Raju Kasambe, you know me. So let us start with our presentation. Today I'm going to talk about breeding behavior of bronze-winged Jacana. This is not a research paper. Okay. This is from the perspective of a bird watcher or a amateur naturalist, like we are, all learners. So when you find something, you don't know what to do. So how to do the study or how to do the documentation. So this is a presentation about how I looked at the breeding behavior of bronze-winged Jacana when I got an opportunity to study. When I came to Mumbai 10 years back, I thought like there is nothing. There are no wetlands and I won't be able to see the Jacanas. Fortunately, from very near, to a place very near from my house, there was a place where I could see Jacanas. So we have two types of Jacanas here in India. The one is pheasant tail Jacana, and this is the breeding plumage you are seeing this slide. It has got a long tail like a pheasant or this curved tail, long curved tail. Okay. And in non-breeding season, it loses this curved tail like a crescent. It loses. So even the female doesn't have it. So the male looks like this. Okay. And again, we have the other species, that is the bronze-winged Jacana. The wings look very much bronze and bronze colored and glossy in breeding plumage. You can see here, that is the breeding plumage. We clicked with the lead buyer batch in Bharatpur. I clicked the one in the breeding plumage. And the other one is the juvenile, which looks very different from the adult. So we'll try to listen to the call of the Jacana. Where is it dropped on me? Nice. Can you hear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, that is the call of the bronze-winged Jacana. Okay. And this is the place where I found the nest. It was a small tank near a temple that's known as Gaudevi tank. And it was not far away from my house. It was around 2 to 3 kilometers from my house. So it was very easy for me to go there every day. And this is like a panoramic view of the tank. You can see Shingada being grown there. And so the laborers will be working and the Jacanas will be walking on this floating vegetation. As you know, Jacanas have long toes and they can easily walk on this type of floating vegetation, particularly where there is a lot of Shingara or lotus or lilies. They can easily walk on them because of their long toes, they can walk. And when they walk, it looks like they are doing catwalk. Okay, you can see the temple on the left side in the slide, and that's the vegetation covered with they were pond covered with vegetation. So what I saw in July 2016, but there was one pair, and they were indulging in courtship. So I thought, yeah, I'm getting a good opportunity to study the Jacanas, and might be I should start documenting. So what I did was I started taking photographs and videographs of their breeding behavior, so that it becomes a document. And I have the habit of writing down all the notes. So on 16th July, we saw that the birds were mating and they were collecting nesting material from the aquatic vegetation and making a platform nest, a nest from the vegetation, which is just around. But it is, let me tell you, it is because the nest is made from vegetation, which is just collected around. You can't see the nest if the bird is not there on the nest. It is totally camouflaged. And when the male sings to attract the female, this is how it sings.
Thank you.
So then I saw mating of those birds, and I realized that the female is bigger than the male. So that's the only difference. Okay, there is no color difference. And once they are away from each other, you can't say which is the male, which is the female. It's very different. Shape and size only you can see when they are together. Then only you can say it's the female is bigger and the male is smaller. Okay, otherwise it's very difficult. Okay. So I saw the floating nest, which was just made up of aquatic weeds and vegetation. The male collected from the nearby shingada plants. So it's very, very well camouflaged. And on 21st July, we found 4 eggs. And the eggs are also greenish, dirty in color, and mottled with blotched brown speckles or dots, whatever you say. So it's very difficult to see the eggs also. So if we see the eggs on 21st, that means 4 eggs. So just calculate 4 days behind. So we calculated that possibly they laid eggs on 17, 18, 19, 20th July, considering that it did not lay on 21st. Okay, 4 days, one egg in each 24 hours. So what happened one day, there was heavy rain and the nest was flooded. So this is how the nest looked from a distance. Okay, because I know I'm clicking it because the bird is there. Otherwise, the platform, you won't be able to see. Everything looks similar. Okay, this is the Bronze-winged Jacana on the nest. And in a close-up, you see now the long toes and the how the Jacana will sit on a nest. It has to fold its legs because it is a very long leg bird and very long toes. Now you can see the eggs. See the eggs. They're so much just like the weeds. So it's very difficult to see the eggs and how the Jacana is going to sit on the eggs. So this is the male. Just I'm telling you, the nest was prepared by the male, and the eggs, the male only is perching on or sitting or incubating the eggs. So what happened? So the male kept incubating the eggs. The female was around. Okay, he took breaks of few minutes for feeding as well as for taking bath. Yeah, they're very careful about taking bath. The female did not help him out in the incubation. The female was around, but she never came and helped in incubation. Sometimes the male crawled. When the male saw the female, it started crying, but she never came back to the nest. Okay. She waited and the male waited and waited for the eggs to hatch. We waited. The male waited for the female to come back. She never came. I had one friend known as Manish Kerkar. I have invited him for this talk, who is an excellent birder from Dombivli. So he and me coordinated on WhatsApp about what is happening at the nest. So because he has got good eyesight, so we visited every day. Either he went there or I went there, and we tried to monitor the nest. So one day I sat there at the nest and decided to calculate the timings. So on 1st August, I found that the male, out of 100 minutes, 83 minutes, the male was on nest. He took breaks for feeding for himself and for taking bath. So these 70 minutes, the eggs were exposed. So if it starts raining, immediately the male will run to the nest and cover the eggs. We don't want the temperature to go down. So what happened after 7 days? On 7th August, there was heavy rain in Mumbai. It was literally flooding, if somebody remembers, 7th August 2016. So the nest was flooded and washed away. And actually, Manish and me, when we went there on 7th August morning, actually we could not look at the nest for a long time. Then I realized that the nest was far away and it was still there in the position. It was still floating. See, Jacanas make floating nests. It's not tied to any weeds. If it is tied, that would have got submerged and it would have got destroyed. So it makes a floating nest. So if there is flooding, the nest floats and changes the location. But the nest is there, the eggs are there, and the male is sitting on it. So that's how the nest was still there. But it was far away. After another 7 days, what happened? 22, 25 days after incubation period, Manish informed me that there are the eggs are hatching. And if you know, Jacana is a bird that is known as precocial. All eggs hatch together, just like hens and ducks. So all the eggs hatch together, and as soon as the eggs hatch, the chicks start walking. So the same is with Jacana and water hen and swamp hens and our domestic chicken and broilers, ducks, geese, swans. All the chicks start running or swimming as soon as they take birth. even left things. So the chick started walking soon after birth, as they were precocial. And the other category is altricial, in which the chicks need the warmth of the parents' body, like the sparrows, crows, babblers, parrots. They are naked. They don't have any feather covers on their body, and they need a lot of care by the parents. But Jacana babies, as soon as they are born, they start walking. So we found that one egg was unhatched, and only three eggs were hatched. So the male tried incubating the fourth egg, and it did not hatch till the evening. But what happened? The male finally decided to quit incubating the egg. Okay, let us see one video. So these are the Jacana baby just born. This is the first day of this baby. You can see one egg there and three babies. They are standing on their feet. They can't even balance themselves properly, but they want to walk. And daddy is not around. Daddy has gone to bring food. Okay, the daddy is coming. So the daddy is coming to the nest. And see how it walks on the wheel. And where are the babies? Can you see the babies now? I can see only two babies and where is the third baby? You can't see the third baby, it's totally camouflaged. It's sitting there, two of them you can see. See the third one, gets up now. So it's a miracle. If you can't see it, I can't see it with so much of zoom of my camera. So one, two, three, a third one got from, we didn't expect where it was. And now the daddy wants to. So now Daddy Jacana wants to take the babies under the wing and take them warm, because after 10-15 minutes the chicks get cold because it is monsoon. Yeah, the baby can't even control it. Okay, where are the babies? And the daddy is trying to incubate the egg now. Okay. So the male tried to keep the chicks under his belly and incubate the eggs incubate the remaining egg, because generally all the eggs should hatch together. Here one egg did not hatch. So what happened?
Please don't tell them. What happened?
Okay, so what happened? We had always dreamed of taking a picture of the Jacana. So 12 p.m. was the time when we wanted to take a dream picture, the photographic moment for which we were waiting. So what is that photographic moment? So I went home and brought my son to capture this event. The male took the chicks under its wings and carried them away from the nest. This is the moment you want to take a picture, and very rare. So this is clicked by my son. You can see the babies, the male is carrying under its wings, just like a mother will carry her baby. So this is the daddy Jacana taking care of the babies and carrying the chicks away from me, because I was there. So it so this is how my son clicked the pictures. You can see the Jacana babies. So this is how my son was sitting there, and the nest was in front of him, and I was far behind him because I had a powerful camera. That's our Nikon P900. This is one. Let us see one more video in which you can see how the daddy takes care of the baby. The babies are there. There is one baby. You can see one more baby under its feet. You may think the quality is not good. It was monsoon and it was very cloudy. It used to rain any time in Mumbai. And the babies want to come out and play around. Yeah, they think they are grown up. Hello. So all the three babies are out. You can see what is happening. Okay. Yeah, now all the babies are out. So the male kept the chicks among, now after the male took the chicks away from the nest, it kept the chicks in the dense vegetation and returned to incubate the remaining egg, that is fourth egg. And in the evening at 5:35 p.m, the male finally decided that the chick, fourth chick is not going to come out, and started pecking on it and decided to destroy the egg possibly or eat it. So the egg tumbled from the nest in the water and floated. See what happens. You have to watch it very carefully. See what's happening. Picking, angry. Picking at the egg. When the egg falls in water, it floats. Okay, the jacana can't find the egg. That's the point. Because it's already broken. So the male escorted the chicks along with him. The male gave them warmth under its wings after every few half an hour rather. The chicks were camouflaged and very difficult to locate until they stood up and started walking. The chicks looked very different from the parents. So it doesn't look like the adult. So these are the chicks. So very difficult to locate from a distance. See how they are moving. Then only you can see them. Okay. See.
Kulajidi sabu aave ni.
Okay, that's how the baby started walking, and then I went back on multiple occasions. After 45 days, I found the jacana babies were as taller as daddy. Okay, and they were still with the daddy. But what happened? Immediately after the babies started walking, the female was seen with involved in courtship behavior and mating with another male on the same tank just nearby. She never responded to the calls of the male, our male, which was feeding nearby with the three chicks. So we decided to stop the observations because the female started mating with the male and they started making another nest. Because that's the same story, we'll repeat. So why the female did not come back to the nest and help the male? So I thought, is it beiman or is it disloyal? When a female mates with multiple males, so she started courting with another male. So when this type of phenomena is observed, the female has got many males in her harem or jananakhana. And this type of breeding strategy is known as polyandry. One female mates with multiple males. So they have, this is known as sex role reversal system of breeding. So the female lays multiple clutches of eggs. One clutch means, those four eggs means one clutch. Four eggs, one clutch. So the father of each clutch is different. So it's every time one male will mate with her, the female will lay eggs. And as soon as she lays eggs, she runs away. And the male takes care of that clutch, thinking that he is the dead. The male only takes care of the eggs and chicks till they fledge from one clutch. Okay. She only keeps on mating and laying eggs. She can lay 5 to 10 clutches. That means 50 eggs in one season, in one monsoon. And the female acts like an egg-laying machine. So what is this? What is this? Why? What are the threats? Why she needs to do this type of... she has to act like this. And why this breeding behavior? There are reasons. Okay, let me try to explain. What are the threats to the jacanas? Why they should do this? Because the habitat is dangerous. You have seen there, it can flood and the entire nest can it just gets swept away. The eggs can fall down from the water. Males destroy eggs if the male doubts that the female is not fidel, is not loyal to him. And there are predators like marsh hyenas, the house crows, jungle crows, all moving around the lakes, and snakes in the water. So they can, anybody can just destroy the nest and eat the eggs. If the eggs roll down, they may sink. That's what we think. In human hunting, once I found that the Shingala workers, they just took the eggs and made omelette. So that also can happen. So that leads into heavy mortality. Death rate is very high. There are birds like hawks, which can eat the jacana babies, even the adult jacana. This is a crested hawk eagle feeding on a jacana baby. So what are the solutions? If there are so many threats to jacanas, what is the solution? So first thing is the nest is floating. So if there is flooding, the nest won't sink. It will just change its place. That is what happened in our case. Okay. The eggs are not round. So they will not roll down. Okay. So at one end they are bigger, the other end they are smaller. So they will make a circle, but won't go like a ball, okay, like a glass ball. They won't roll down. They will just rotate around. The eggs can float. That's the one thing we saw in the video. The eggs can float. So if the egg floats, the jacana will just pick it up and take it to another place where it will make, it had already made a nest, and put the egg on the nest or even on a floating leaf of a lotus. Just on one leaf, the jacana can make lay four eggs and incubate the entire clutch or brood. So that's so easy for jacana to carry the egg and just put it on a leaf and then start incubating. And daddy, this is done by daddy only. Daddy jacana, not mom jacana. Okay. So that is one more strategy. Okay, the male color looks like shining water. That is the bronze color. If you look from sky, the harrier will look like. The harrier will look at whether there is some prey. And the jacana just shines just like the water is shining, so it can't find the jacana sitting on the nest. And when the jacana is perching on the nest, it won't move, so it doesn't look like anything, any living object. So, and they can carry the eggs, of course. As I say, you can see a photograph of pheasant tail jacana carrying the egg. This is a very rare photograph, and even bronze winged jacana has been photographed carrying the eggs. You can see the nest on one leaf of lotus or a lily here. And what is the last solution? The jacanas have adapted. The final answer to heavy mortality is to lay more and more eggs, to give birth to more and more chicks. Who can lay eggs? Only females. But who will take care of so many eggs? The female can't do everything. So she just lays eggs and runs away. And gives charge of the things to the daddy. to the male jacana. Thus, polyandry is the answer to the problems faced by jacanas. So each male has to, however, take care of only one family. You may think the daddy is great. No, he has to take care of only four chicks. Look at the mother. So many eggs she is laying. She is becoming mother for so many chicks. But she won't do for enjoyment. She is the real mother who wants to continue the race of the jacanas by working hard physically, by laying so many eggs in one season. So she has to work hard. Just imagine the pressure on her system. So that's how my study or my observations conclude. And I stop here. So I wish you happy window birding for now. Please stay at home. Please participate in the birding challenge posted by eBird. Do birding from your window or terrace. Follow social distancing guidelines as given by the government. Happy birding and over to Priyanka. Priyanka.
Yes, sir. So if you have any doubts, you can unmute yourself and you can ask the questions. Yeah.
You have to, the one who wants to ask the question has to unmute the mic. And as soon as you ask the question, again mute it. So others can hear. Others can listen.
Raju sir, I was watching this video as a daddy along with my son. So we really enjoyed the story.
Jain sir, you just tell your name and the place you are talking from. So others can hear.
Dilip Jain from Girgaon. I am part of Lead Bio course. So I was watching this video with my son. So we really enjoyed the whole story. Thank you so much. Yes.
Thank you. Next question.
Raju sir, Francis here. I have disabled my video. Very good session. Thank you. Since you have already covered Jacana, I'm sure you can also cover your small poetry on Jacana as well. Today for us.
Okay, let me find. Okay, by the time next question.
Hi, hello.
Hello, sir. This is Radhika here. I wanted to ask whether the jacana in the video you showed, the jacana destroys the egg, right?
Yes.
The egg which was not incubated, it just drops it. Huh?
Yeah, it tried to destroy the egg. Might be it wanted to eat or something. We don't know what happened.
Okay, thank you, sir. The session was very good, sir.
Oh, thanks.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, hi, this is Keku from Hyderabad. Sir, I wanted to ask you, what were the other birds with which jacanas was sharing the nesting space?
No other bird was there nesting.
Okay.
No other species was nesting at that time.
How many male jacanas were there at the same time?
There were two pairs. Two were far away and this pair. But after some time, I could see only male at the nest, and this female was gone with the one more bird.
Hello, Raju sir. This is Anil Bahirat from Hyderabad. Yeah. So my question is, how about other birds, sir? Like, did you get a chance to observe them, like coots or grebes? Coots also, I saw that they also made floating nest when I used to observe them 2 years back. Of late, I am unable to see many of them because of the vegetation, loss of vegetation. But is that true with coots also?
No. What is the last sentence?
Coots. COOT. Coot.
No. What is the last sentence of your question?
Is the same situation with coots also, because they also have a floating nest I observed them?
No. The polyandry, you mean male, multiple males and one female?
Correct.
No. Yeah. It's not there. It's in jacanas. There are some other species in which this happens. That is the pentate snipes, it happens. So The best example is greater pendant snipe, which is found in our area, and the common quails, bustard quails. That is the barred button quail, yellow leg button quail, the three species of button quails. This happens. Same thing, polyandry. Okay, not in many species. Yeah, and the reverse happens in bioweavers. Okay. A male mates with multiple females. Okay. That is known as polygamy.
They have also similar kind of nesting habitat, so I was just trying to understand that better.
Yeah, yeah. But little grebes was very interesting nesting. The grebe carries the babies on its back. Okay, so that is also very interesting. Little grebe as well as great crested grebe. That's very interesting. Okay, but not polyandry. Okay, polyandry is very rare. It's very rare in birds. Okay.
Thank you very much, sir. It was very wonderful session.
Welcome.
Hello.
Raju sir, Awad here.
Raju sir.
Awad.
Sir, pigeon tail jacanas also have similar habitat. I have seen them BKC at the same time. So
yes.
Their breeding time is also same or they have different breeding time? And
No.
Is there any threat to each other from...
No threat. They might compete, but they don't compete with each other. There is no threat.
Okay.
There is no threat. They can nest together. Okay.
Hello, sir. It's Vinit. Hello.
Yeah. Vinit.
Yes, sir. What are the food of the jacana? What they eat normally?
They are mostly vegetarian. They eat the shoots of the shingada and aquatic plants. But if there are some insects they can find, they will take.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Occasional. Yes, welcome, Vinit.
Sir, this is Navneet, sir.
Yeah, Navneet, boliye.
Sir, two questions, sir. One is there any local migration or any pattern by the jacanas? And secondly, sir, the breeding, is it seasonal? Is it particular season? Availability of food?
No, it's seasonal. It's in monsoon because monsoon has got a lot of aquatic vegetation. So it's very safe for them. And breeding, it's a local resident for India. So might be they are migrating some distance, but not much. And actually nobody has done any research, but they're residents. So we can suppose that they don't migrate. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, welcome.
And this is
Amit
here
from Mumbai.
Yeah.
You said that they eat the vegetation or the shingada vegetation. When the farmers will the farmers not shoo them away in that case? The shingada farmers.
No. It's not much. It's not much. The entire lake was covered with the shingada, and only four jacanas were there. So makes no difference.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Makes no difference. If there are 1,000 jacanas, then they will be bothered.
Hello, sir. Preni here.
Yeah.
Sir, hello, you said.
Yeah, Preni first.
Okay, sir. You said after 45 days when you went back to visit the location, the chicks had grown up, but they were still with the father, right? So how long?
Yes.
Yeah. So how long are they dependent on the parent? Like when do they start moving out on their own?
I think another 2-3 months they will be with the parents. They will be with the daddy, not mother. Mother never comes back.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. Amazing presentation.
Yes.
Hello.
I wanted to know peasant tail jacana and bronze wing jacana breeding behavior is same in both the species. This thing.
Nearly similar. There are lots of research papers on those, but I just avoided adding research papers and concentrated on what I saw and how we analyze it. Okay, instead of just talking about the complex research papers, you can read some research papers. There are a lot of research papers on those, but similar, very similar breeding behavior in both. Both are polyandrous. The female behaves similarly, and there are many species of jacana outside India. There also. Polyandrous. Okay. That's the interesting thing. All jacanas, you can say.
All jacanas. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Hello.
Yeah, hi. I am Shomu from Kolkata. I just wanted to know, when the chicks hatch, is the ratio of male and female same, or is it skewed?
No, I don't know. I don't know.
Okay, and
might be there are some. We have to find out.
And in one area, how many females can be found? I can imagine there will be several males, but are there several females also around, or she has some pedigree?
What I think is there should be more males. That is what I think. Than the number of females.
She maintains some sort of pedigree.
So because this part where I did the observation, it's very small pond, only four birds, only four jacanas, and one or two water hens moving around. That's all. Not many birds.
Okay.
Very small pond actually.
Okay. And they breed equally well in water hyacinths also, right?
No, equally well. What? What is it? Can you repeat?
Water hyacinths.
Yes, yes, of course. Any aquatic vegetation, they don't discriminate.
Hello, sir. Radhika again here. Radhika. Has any bronze-winged jacana been ringed in the recent past? Any information?
No, I'm not aware. We are just not doing on jacanas. We are doing mostly on waders.
Okay. On waders. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, Priti.
Sir, you said during your observation there were pair, as in two sets of jacanas where they were in their fight for territorial when they were laying eggs.
Sometimes they had fights, yes. When these the other birds came near this nest, this male attacked the male, the other male actually, okay, and thwarted its attempts to come nearby. So that was there. So there was a small bund in the middle of the lake. So the other pair kept to the other side. This kept to the towards my side.
Very interesting presentation, sir.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Andrila.
Hello. Hi, sir. This is very interesting. So, one question. The male one is calling for the mating. The female one, right?
No, yes.
As if the species is polyandrous, so I thought the female one is call.
Not for mating. I'm saying after the female lays eggs, the male calls. The male is it's like crying, please come, please help me. Like that.
Okay. It should be in the process. I mean, they should know that this is the process. But why they are crying like that? I mean, why they expect? I mean, the expectation shouldn't be there.
Males are male.
This is the natural process.
Males are crying, baby.
Thank you, sir.
Jacanas. Okay, that's interesting.
Atmanja.
Yeah, Pampi.
Yes. Sir, I'm Atmaja. Is there any report that the jacana, the female jacana, she comes back? Is there any report the jacana comes back once after she leaves the male?
The female comes back?
Yeah, does the female come back?
Again.
Ever again?
No,
we saw that thing. There two jacanas were in the same nest in the Royal Botanic Garden here. Two jacanas same nest, and the chicks were also there. We saw one.
Oh, that's person. Good. That's good. That's very good. It may happen sometimes. See, these observations are from only one nest and only one clutch or one breeding attempt. So if there are observations on 10, 15 nests, we may get better data and then we can write a research paper actually. But with you only one observation,
you can't be 100%
sure.
8 to 9 nests were there in the same pond.
Yes, yes, this is very interesting. It is very interesting. Yes, yes, you should write down.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You should write down these observations. It's very important. Atmaja, it's very important. Good observation.
Sir, the presentation was really nice.
Thanks, Atmaja.
The presentation was really nice, and I saw it for the second time, I think. We saw it once in Jamnagar there.
Oh, yes, yes, yeah.
The presentation, second time. Okay. It was really nice.
So one small question.
Okay. Shomu, Oliye.
Yes. So, which month is a good time to start to search for the nest and start observing?
As soon as the monsoon starts, June.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Shomu, thanks. Okay. Priyanka.
Yes, sir.
You want to conclude?
I hope if you guys have no doubts, we can conclude the session. Thank you so much.
You want to listen to my poem?
You can share it afterwards on WhatsApp.
Yes, sir. Definitely, we would like to hear your poem.
So, I will record. I have recorded this session, so we will be uploading on YouTube. So, you can also refer afterwards whenever you feel like. And I'll share the link with you all.
Yeah.
Thank you so
okay.
much.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Priyanka.
Also, be safe. Don't go out. Be safe at home. And join. We are posting the sessions information, online session information on Facebook and Instagram. So if you find any difficulty, like we are posting, suppose the session is tomorrow, we'll post the session information or registration form today. So one day before we post it. So if you feel like you are not able to register, please mail us or ping us on WhatsApp. We will share the registration link with you. For next session, next online session. Actually, they are for
those are for general public. And what is happening, as soon as we share the link, it's getting full in 1 or 2 hours.
Yes.
So we are also facing problem. We want to give you priority, but it's very difficult. You are already with us. We can have special presentations for you, but we also want that more public should join our programs. So that's why we have to post it on BNHS. Facebook page and group, so that we also reach other people. As an organization, we have to try to reach to more and more people. So we have decided to have sessions for you as well as sessions for them. So this session, today's session, is only for our course participants, except few invitees. So it's good to meet you all, and we will be meeting in further online sessions. Let's hope the corona epidemic thing is over, and we can meet soon in some program. We would like to organize for both the courses. Okay. It will be my pleasure. And it's always a joy to meet you all.
Yes, sir. We are also waiting for to again meet and do birding session. We are always waiting for this.
Okay. Okay, that was great, and I think we can conclude the session here. It was very nice to see all your faces, smiling faces, and interact with you. And I want to be back in field. I'm sorry, I had my own problems and I could not come for field visits. And it was even disappointing for me that I could not go out for such a long time, and then this corona thing came, and again I am locked inside the house. But this medium has given us an opportunity to interact, and I am also doing a lot of window birding. That's the only way out I can keep myself entertained. So please do that. Please take care of yourself. Please take care of your families, and we will soon meet. Even if the course duration is finished, we'll try to organize something so that we can meet and interact. Okay.
Yeah.
So have a nice time and enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.